slower, Hedge.
I can go slower, Hedge. Come on down and chump some of this shit.
Look, you better get your ass on, hunky, while I still let you.
That's right, bitch.
That's what you better do. The fuck you think you is?
Ever notice how you come across somebody once in a while that you shouldn't have fucked with? That's me.
Put the evidence in the back. There's no way that you could come from my loins. Soon as I get home, the first thing I'm gonna do is punch your mama in the mouth.
Who's your friend in a Volkswagen?
Huh? Yeah, he followed us here.
When did he start following?
No! Fuck! Hey.
In the limo, you son of a bitch. No arguments.
Hey, careful, man. There's a beverage here, huh?
Here's the first of the day, fellas. To old D.H. Lawrence.
Nick. Indians.
I'd like a plain omelet, no potatoes, tomatoes instead, a cup of coffee, and wheat toast.
No substitution.
What do you mean, you don't have any tomatoes?
Only what's on the menu. You can have a number two, a plain omelet. It comes with cottage fries and rolls.
Yeah, I know what it comes with, but it's not what I want.
Well, I'll come back when you make up your mind.
Wait a minute. I have made up my mind. I'd like a plain omelet, no potatoes on the plate, a cup of coffee, and a side order of wheat toast.
I'm sorry, we don't have any side orders of toast I'll give you off. English muffin or a coffee roll.
What do you mean you don't make side orders of toast? You make sandwiches, don't you?
Would you like to talk to the manager?
Hey, Mac.
Shut up. You've got bread and a toaster of some kind?
I don't make the rules.
Okay, I'll make it as easy for you as I can. I'd like an omelet, plain, and a chicken salad sandwich on wheat toast. No mayonnaise, no butter, no lettuce, and a cup of coffee.
A number two, chicken salad sand. Hold the butter, the lettuce, the mayonnaise, and a cup of coffee. Anything else?
Yeah, now all you have to do is hold the chicken, bring me the toast, give me a check for the chicken salad sandwich, and you haven't broken any rules.
You want me to hold the chicken, huh?
I want you to hold it between your knees.
You see that sign, sir? Yes, you all have to leave. I'm not taking any more of your smartness and sarcasm.
You see this sign?
Well, that's a little hard to say.
Ben.
Excuse me. Mr. McGuire.
Ben.
Mr. McGuire.
Come with me for a minute. I want to talk to you. Excuse us, Joanne.
Of course.
Thank you. He is such a friend. I look at him and I can't believe it. I simply can't believe it.
I just want to say one word to you. Just one word.
Yes, sir.
Are you listening?
Yes, I am.
Plastics.
Exactly. How do you mean?
There's a great future in plastics. Think about it. Will you think about it?
Yes, I will.
I've said, that's a deal.
Are you employed, Mr. Lebowski?
Wait, let me explain something to you. I am not Mr. Lebowski. You're Mr. Lebowski. I'm the dude. So that's what you call me, you know? His dudeness, or duder, or, you know, El Duderino, if you're not into the whole brevity thing.
Are you employed, sir?
Employed?
You don't go out looking for a job dressed like that, do you? On a weekday?
Is this a... What day is this?
Butch, I got something for you. This watch I got here was first purchased by your great-grandfather during the First World War. It was bought in a little general store in Knoxville, Tennessee. Made by the first company to ever make wristwatches. Up till then, people just carried pocket watches. It was bought by Private Doughboy Orion Coolidge on the day he set sail for Paris. This was your great-grandfather's war watch, and he wore it every day he was in that war. And he'd done his duty, went home to your great-grandmother, took the watch off, put an old coffee can, and in that can it stayed till your granddad, Dane Coolidge, was called upon by his country to go overseas and fight the Germans once again. It's time they called it World War II. Great-grandfather gave this watch to your granddad for good luck. Unfortunately, Dane's luck wasn't as good as his old man's. Dane was a Marine, and he was killed, along with all the other Marines at the Battle of Wake Island. Granddad was facing death. He knew it. None of those boys had any illusions about ever leaving that island alive. So 3 days before the Japanese took the island, your granddad asked a gunner on an Air Force transport named a Wanaki, man he never met before in his life, to deliver to his infant son, we'd never seen in the flesh, his gold watch. 3 days later, your granddad was dead, but Wanaki kept his word. After the war was over, he paid a visit to your grandmother, delivering to your infant father his dad's gold watch. This watch. This watch was on your daddy's wrist when he was shot down over Hanoi. He was captured, put in a Vietnamese prison camp. He knew that if the gooks ever saw the watch, it'd be confiscated, taken away. The way your dad looked at it, this watch was your birthright. You'd be damned if any slope's gonna put the greasy yellow hands on his boy's birthright, so he hid it. In one place he knew he could hide something, his ass. 5 long years he wore this watch, up his ass. Then he died of dysentery. Give me the watch. I hid this uncomfortable hunk of metal up my ass 2 years. Then, after 7 years, I was sent home to my family. Now, little man, I give the watch to you.
We got somebody for you.
You must be Stan. How you doing?
Why'd they bring you in here?
Well, I just got in. I asked where the new guys were, and they brought me right in. Hey, he's sleeping, huh? Cute little guy. You know, maybe I'll just start with you. I'll let him sleep a little bit.
Look, I don't want to do this.
Hey, I don't blame you. If I was in your situation, I'd want to get through this whole thing as quickly and with as little pain as possible. So, you know, let's try our best to make it a simple in-and-out procedure. What's the matter? Relax. You know, Maybe we should spend a couple of minutes together, you know, to get acquainted before we, you know, before we get to it. What's wrong with you?
I don't want to do this.
But I understand, but, you know, what are your alternatives?
My alternatives?
Yeah.
To what, to you? I don't know. Suicide? Death?
Look, it's either me or them. You're getting fucked one way or the other. Hey. Lighten up, okay? Don't worry, I'm gonna help you.
Gee, thanks.
Excuse me, but I think a modicum of gratitude would not be out of line here.
You think I should be grateful?
Yeah, I mean, it's your ass, not mine. I think you should be grateful. I think you should be down on your fucking knees.
Well, I'm sorry, I didn't know it was such an honor to get a visit from you.
Hey, I'm doing a favor here, you know. You're getting me for nothing, you little fuck.
Boy, that's one hell of an ego you've got.
What the fuck is your problem? I did not come down here just to get jerked off, no. You know.
No. I'm not jerking you off. I'm not doing anything.
That's it. You're on your own. I'm just taking care of Sleeper Beauty.
It's a hell of a thing, killing a man. You take away all he's got, and all he's ever gonna have.
Yeah. Well, I guess they had it coming.
We all have it coming, Captain.